you hear me, comrades?
Yes.
Good. A few words, if I may. We're here gathered here at the BBC. The BBC hasn't just become the Biased Broadcasting Corporation. It's always been a voice piece, a spokesperson for the ruling classes in this country. Whether it was a general strike, whether it was the miners, whether it's any group of workers or people fighting for their liberation, the BBC has always been on the wrong side, on the side of oppression, on the side of repression. So it's no accident that with the election of Jeremy Corbyn as the leader of the Labour Party, that it immediately gave voice to those seeking to destabilise him with the so-called anti-Semitism narrative. And we should also be quite clear at the moment that the position is particularly dangerous and vulnerable for Jeremy Corbyn. The ruling class, quite simply, is scared. Scared that Theresa May's government will collapse of its own contradictions over Brexit. What has also instigated and prompted the ruling class and the BBC is the fact that the left finally gained control of the national executive and got rid of the hated Ian McNichol. And they were quite determined to step up the anti-Semitism attack. Because let us be under no doubt, what are these allegations of anti-Semitism against Jeremy Corbyn? And remember, when it first started, it was against people like me, people like Mark Wadsworth. But they've realised that going for individuals like us, collateral damage, is really no point in doing that. So they've gone for Corbyn himself. And what have they done? They found an erased mural 6 years ago. That was the start of it. Now it is a meeting of a Holocaust survivor, a Jewish Holocaust survivor from Auschwitz, who had the audacity to compare his own experiences with those of the Palestinians in Israel today. Well, I say, it is not only disgraceful the attack on him, and I was reading an article by Ian Birrell in The Eye yesterday, who referred to Hajir Meir, the Holocaust survivor, as just an ordinary person. He didn't even mention that he was a Holocaust survivor. And that is how outrageous the distortion in the media and in the BBC is. They completely want to trample over any truth, over any facts, because what they're concerned about is getting rid of Corbyn and making the Labour Party safe for Chuka Ramona, Margaret Hodge, and all the rest of it. Imagine if Margaret Hodge had been on our side, just supposing.